Did you know that Africa is home to both the tallest people on Earth and some of the shortest, all within the same racial group? At first glance, it sounds impossible, almost like a contradiction of nature. But this actually shows how deeply our environment, food, and history shape our bodies. Human height is not random. It's an evolutionary story written across continents, jungles, deserts, and icy tundras. It tells us how our ancestors survived in the world around them. From rainforest dwellers averaging under 5 feet to Neolithic giants well over 6 feet, our height reflects a constant balancing act between biology and environment. This video is going to break a lot of stereotypes about human height. For example, African pygmies aren't actually the shortest people in the world. The Dutch aren't the tallest Europeans. And there were once entire tribes of giants you've probably never heard of, along with extinct pygmy groups as well. So stick around until the end and let me know what you think in the chat. But before we dive in, a quick announcement. If you're interested in discovering your personal phenotype, check out my small business where I create custom phenotype assessment reports. These are detailed reports I put together after analyzing your traits and identifying which phenotype group you belong to, including a percentage breakdown if you're mixed. Inside, you'll learn everything about your phenotype, its history, health tendencies, immunity, behavioral traits, and even lifespan. It's the safest and most affordable journey of self-discovery you can take. The link and details are in the description. Now let's get into the video. For most of human history, height was determined not just by our genes, but also by what we ate and how we lived. Malnutrition kept people shorter in early farming societies, while hunter-gatherers with more diverse diets often grew taller. Industrialization brought sugar, meat, and calorie-rich foods, which pushed human height upward, though sometimes at the cost of new health problems like obesity and diabetes. Diseases could also stunt growth, keeping people below their natural potential. Across the world, populations adapted differently, which is why Africa today holds the widest of human heights found anywhere on Earth. One of the most striking examples is very short stature, defined as an average adult male height under 4 feet 11 inches, or about 150 centimeters. This height is often found in tropical rainforests, where being small is a big advantage. Short bodies overheat less easily in hot, humid conditions and make it easier to move through thick undergrowth. Rainforest diets, often low in protein and heavy in fruits, roots, and small game, also favor smaller body sizes. The Ayomi of New Guinea, with men averaging only 4 feet 6 inches, or 138 centimeters, are the lowest known. The Mbuti pygmies of Central Africa, the Ada of the Philippines, and the Andamanese Negritos of the Indian Ocean all show the same adaptation, shaped by rainforest environments. Next is short stature, where men average between 4 feet 11 and 5 feet 3 inches, or 150 to 160 centimeters. This type is common in harsh regions like deserts and Arctic lands. In the cold, shorter limbs reduce heat loss. In deserts or mountains with scarce food, compact bodies need fewer calories to survive. Diets here were often limited to hunting small animals, tubers, or fish. Native Americans in the mountain forests from southern Mexico to Peru often fall into this group. In Africa, the Twa and Baka forest peoples, along with the Khoisan of the Kalahari Desert, are shorter. In Asia, Vedoid groups of India, Indochina's mountain peoples, the Sunda Islanders, and the now extinct Queensland Forest Aborigines share this stature. Even the Inuit of the Arctic and Siberian groups developed shorter, stockier frames to conserve body heat. Rather short stature, about 5 feet 3 to 5 feet 5 inches, or 160 to 165 centimeters, is a middle ground between short and medium. This is common in Asia, South America, and colder parts of the world. In these regions, people balanced the need to conserve heat with the need for mobility. Diets were often mixed: fish, grains, and small game, which supported moderate growth. Many indigenous groups of Japan, Siberia, and Indochina fall here, as do native Mexicans and Amazonian tribes. In Europe, groups in southern Italy, the Carpathians, and Lapland show this pattern. In Africa, some Khoisan and Central African peoples also fall into this category. Medium height, around 5 feet 5 to 5 feet 8 inches, or 165 to 173 centimeters, represents the world's average. This stature works in nearly all climates, making it a sort of universal balance. it can come from natural adaptation or mixing between tall and short populations. Balanced diets with grains, meat, and dairy often support this middle height. Bantu peoples of Central Africa, Madagascans, and Southern Australian Aborigines are medium height. In Europe, many Central and Eastern Europeans fall here. In Asia, Northern Chinese, Indians, and other East Asians often average this range. Rather tall stature, about 5 feet 8 to 5 feet 10 inches, or 173 to 178 centimeters, is common in open grasslands and savannas. Tall frames may have helped hunters cover wide distances and spot prey over tall grass. Diets richer in meat and milk, typical of herding and pastoral societies, supported greater growth. North Africans, Bantu of the savannas, and Northern Australian Aborigines are often rather tall. In Europe, Germans, Ukrainians, and Romanians show this stature, while in West Asia, Kurds, Persians, and North Indians often fall here. Plains tribes in Canada and the Rocky Mountains also showed rather tall averages. Tall stature, between 5 feet 10 and 6 feet 1 inch, or 178 to 185 centimeters, is especially linked to pastoral and grassland peoples. Long limbs and lean bodies are perfect for releasing heat in hot, dry climates. High-protein diets rich in cattle milk, meat, and blood helped fuel this height. The Nilotic peoples of East Africa, like the Maasai and Dinka, are famously tall. So are the Somalis and Tuareg of the Sahara. In Europe, northern populations and those from the Dinaric Alps are tall, with the Dinaric people once being the tallest Europeans, until the Dutch experienced a dramatic growth spurt in modern times, going from around 5 feet 5 inches to about 6 feet. Plains tribes in North America, such as the Sioux, were often tall, while Patagonian peoples in South America also reached impressive heights. Polynesians, with diets rich in fish and taro, also tend toward this stature. Finally, there are the very tall populations, averaging over 6 feet 1 inch, or 185 centimeters. Before modern times, this was almost unheard of, except in a few special cases. In Africa, the Nuer of South Sudan averaged about this height, along with their neighbors, the Dinka, Shilluk, and Tutsi. Their bodies are long-legged and slender, perfectly adapted to hot, open environments where tall builds help radiate heat. Their cattle-based diet, rich in milk, blood, and meat, also fueled growth. Outside Africa, inland Patagonian groups like the Tehuelche and Selknam once reached similar heights. But unlike the Nelos, they were bulky rather than slender, shaped by a meat-heavy diet of guanaco and fish. Sadly, these Patagonian giants are now extinct. When you step back and look at the map, a clear pattern emerges. In dense rainforests, shorter bodies are the rule. In deserts and savannas, tall statures dominate. In temperate climates, people often fall somewhere in the middle. Geography writes itself into our very bones. And the time scale is shorter than you might expect. In Europe and East Asia, better diets during just the last few centuries added inches within a handful of generations. This proves that human height is flexible and responsive. But height is not just biology. It also carries social weight. Around the world, taller people are often given higher status, while shorter people face stereotypes, rejection, and even oppression, even though both are natural evolutionary outcomes of survival. What began as an adaptation to climate and food supply has become a marker of beauty, power, and identity in modern society. And so, the story of human height is more than numbers on a measuring tape. It is the story of how we evolved, how we eat, how we live, and even how we see one another today. And speaking of how we look, check out the personalized phenotype assessment report in the description. You can also explore the story behind our diverse skin colors and hair textures. And as always, stay curious, stay smart, and thank you very much for watching.